Hi, what's up, buddy? Welcome to Rich Talk Insider. Let's talk about Tesla stock and AMC stock predictions. If this is your first time to Rich Talk Insider, we talk about stock investing, cryptocurrency trading, and how to make money in real estate as a realtor. So if you want to make more money, you can subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss out any of our videos. Get your free stocks and audiobooks in the description and comment at the end of the video. Today, let's talk about what's going on with the Tesla. How about AMC? Could it go up more or could it go down? So let's talk about it today. And we're going to talk about what's happening in the stock market and cryptocurrency market today. So June 3rd, stock markets are basically mostly red. S&P 500 was down, especially Nasdaq was down 1.03%. Russell was down, crude oil, as I predicted, it just keep climbing. Of course, because economy is opening up, you know, a lot of people are traveling, the flights are flying, so we need more oil, you know, oil, crude oil. So that's very normal. That's a good sign of great economy. So, and also gold and silver hovering around 1800, 1900, silver 27, 28. So I think this could go up more if the inflation kick in. And remember, inflation, there are two parts. Commodities like coffee, lumber, you know, sugar, like general commodities, they're gonna keep climbing, but technological gonna have deflation. Because let's look at battery or solar panel, their prices are going to go down in future. So in a way, deflation in the technology is good. You know, that a lot of people can use those technologies to increase productivity. And increase in the commodity prices, this is normal. You know, we just came out of pandemic, so it's an indication of getting back into the normal economy. 10-year bond jumped to 1.62, but remember, before pandemic, during normal time, it's around 2-3%. So we are still very, very low, you know, in a 10-year bond year. So if it is jump higher, depending on percentage jump, it could impact the stock market. USD appreciate against Japanese yen, British pound, and euro. So this is probably today one of the days that, you know, USD appreciates against most currency. Bitcoin is trying to break out 40,000. Other cryptocurrency were also up. Then the stock exchange was down. Nickel was also up. So Ethereum is 2,818 right now. So if you bought it at 2011, you know, 114 congratulation. If you bought it at 4,000, you need to be looking at long term. Basically, you know, crypto is here to stay. U.S. government is not looking to burn, because they are looking to test cryptocurrency to get more test revenue. So that's good news to me. U.S. government is most likely not gonna ban back. Other governments overseas, maybe China, we don't know for sure. You know, so it's a good idea to have a portfolio, you know, diversified portfolio. Don't put 50% or 80% in cryptocurrency. You personally, I like to put only maybe at maximum 10% in crypto. Ethereum and Dogecoin hasn't moved so much, $69.40. It jumped from 30 cents to 40 cents. It could be because of Coinbase listing Dogecoin pretty soon. June 3rd, the hottest stocks, the most traded stocks were Sendai, AMC, BlackBerry, Naked Brands, and Ford. So all these are like penny stock, you know, penny stock, and Ford is probably the only one blue chip stock, over 63 billion. AMC is now 31 billion, half of the Ford. So AMC dropped, so I'm gonna tell you why it dropped. Sendai also jumped because of the good news, and Meso is trying to support the legalization. And so BlackBerry also most traded stock as well. So most of the Tesla was down, you know, 5.33%. Microsoft, all the technologies, most of the technologies were down except Nvidia, and the other stocks were up. But because the biggest stocks went down, it dragged the whole stock market, you know. The S&P 500, Nasdaq, especially Tesla, so it dragged down the market. So Tesla, what's going on with Tesla? Tesla has a safety issue. Tesla recalling about 6,000 vehicles over the brake caliper bolts, and that could potentially cause a loss of tire pressure. So if you have Tesla models 3 and model 4, model Y between 2019 to 2021, you could probably call a Tesla to arrange for the recall, fix the issue. And also Tesla, one report said Tesla net orders in China dropped to 9,800 in May from 18,000 in April. That's half of the, that's basically half. So that's why it dropped. Tesla price dropped today. So CNBC has not corroborated that report. Remember, Tesla has been having some issue with Chinese authority over safety issue, safety investigation. That's really normal. And remember, Tesla is not the only one. So there are a lot of competitors coming out, especially NIO, XPeng in China, and also Ford and GM, and try to shift to the EV market. So Tesla was the first, but it's not alone. So China probably favor NIO and XPeng. So what is my prediction? I believe Tesla's gonna be range bound, you know, between $400 to $700. It's gonna be trading sideways in 2021 because it jumped a lot in 2019 and 2020. So it could potentially go down to $300 depending on how big the issue that is they gonna have. And also how about inflation? If the interest will jump, that could impact the Tesla stock. So back as a long-term investor, you know, I already predicted Tesla's stock gonna hit 900 back in November. It hit a few months later in January, February. You can go to see the Tesla stock playlist on my YouTube channel. AMC is trading going down and was going up today, very very crazy. It's because the AMC issued new shares. That's very normal. As a CEO of AMC, I would do the same. You know, that's the best time to issue shares because the AMC stock jumped crazy to $60, $70. So, they are issued the shares. So they raised $587 million. They sold 11.55 million shares. So, at the market equity program launched earlier in Thursday, that's why it dropped. Remember, AMC could potentially issue more shares, so that's not enough. So let's look at the test. AMC has a price target of $6, so this analyst issue price target is which is less than $14 average movie ticket price. So because AMC has 5.5 billion debt, and remember, AMC could probably borrow more money to maintain the movie theaters, probably acquire new bankrupt movie theaters as well. So this could potentially go up. CapEx gonna go up, and they need to pay for the deferred rent about $450 million, and the CapEx is minus $100 million. Remember, if AMC closed theaters, they still need to do maintenance. You know, it's not just like they can shut down everything and forget about it. They also have a high annual interest of $420 million. So even if you make profits of $420 million, that's already good. But AMC couldn't make profits because it has so much debt. So all the profits gonna go to debt service, you know, interest payment $420 million. So analysts are also expecting AMC losing money, $2.5 billion from 2021-2023. So remember, AMC, the best time is after recovery. You know, in 2021-2022, a lot of people are gonna go to cinema. But even so, if they couldn't make profits, I don't see the future of AMC. This analyst Richard said AMC is gonna go bankrupt. It's what only one said. The reason why he said that AMC is not changing the industry. Tesla is changing the car industry. AMC is just a movie theater. The same movie theaters 5 years ago versus today. But one thing that could potentially change AMC if they innovate, if they add more, you know, restaurant, they are adding food service in a movie theater, and also if they do 3D 4D theaters, a lot of people, they need to keep people coming to the movie theaters because movie studios are also releasing the movies on the same day on online streaming. So that definitely impact the movie theaters as well. And another thing that I could potentially see is if marijuana use is legalized in US, if people can use marijuana in AMC. But that could not probably not happen, because even though marijuana could have a high margin, using marijuana in the movie theater is probably not a cool idea. So that could probably not happening. So I wish all the best for AMC. I will be waiting and see how they are going to innovate. And also remember, they need to issue more share, probably 50 million or 100 million more shares to cover for the, to dilute the shares. They need a lot of permission from the, you know, retail investor. So if, even if the investor agreed for the dilution, is going to be so huge that I could see AMC stock going down. After all the hype is over, you know, AMC is not as good a company as the cinema. So if the hype is over, or if the crypto becomes harder, or if the pot other stocks become harder, the AMC stock could go down. As a long-term investor, I wouldn't touch AMC, but sure, for short term, yeah, sure, it's good to trade because it's very popular stock. So that's my AMC prediction. You can get free stocks and crypto in the description. If you want to join Stock Membership Club, you can join. I send out a lot for growth stock, dividend stock, also crypto for the limited time. Get free stocks in the description, and get cryptocurrency in the description as well. So thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.